Hi, I'm John. This is my show, An American Scheme, where I'm proving that Diana Ross is Michael Jackson's actual mother.
And he tried to manifest that in the way he would dress, in the way he would look, in the way he changed his entire physicality to become something different. But more importantly, I always felt that his brain was being pulled in two different directions.
What? The part right there that his brain... See, now, he would never know the Diana Ross story, right? So he sees things, but... You know, he's going to use his interpretation of what he sees, and there's going to be things that he sees, but there's going to be, he doesn't know the story of the Diana Ross, that Michael's not, because nobody could see that Michael's not Jackson, because he was raised a Jackson, he was a Jackson. I mean, when people yell at me, because it's one of those things, oh, you're going to take Michael out of the Jacksons? I mean, come on, how are you going to pull that magic trick off? I mean, come on, that's what I'm saying. For people to think that I would actually come in here and I would try and pull that off, I mean, come on. How would I try and pull that off unless I actually believed it and actually think it is true and I can prove it? Because there's no way. That's like, you're trying to, what I'm going up against? Come on.
I'm very influenced by young, angelic people or images or impressions or children. He just was drawn towards that. And the fact that there was an evil side, that truly it's even a handsome evil. It's not a dark, it's a theatrical evil. And I think he wore that mask very, very well, because he fooled people by trying to be very childlike. And that's why I put the flowers in there. They're kind of kitschy, like, oh, a man like this could never be like that. When in fact, deep down inside, you strip off the clothes, he sees himself as a very aggressive human being. Even though he comes off as this passive individual, Michael Jackson was a dynamo, and he was one.
I like to stop it just because of the copyright stuff, you know, just technically it's better to stop things a little bit. But so when you're seeing Sylvester Stallone talking about Michael Jackson seeing himself as a dynamo, there was just the one thing about Michael Jackson that's his talent is just so obvious. And when he went out and danced and the way he performed, it's so aggressive. And that's like what he's saying, he's a dynamo. But he represents this child nature and all this innocence thing too. And he's being pulled apart, you know. And I really like hearing Sylvester Stallone speaking about here. But you gotta remember, Stallone doesn't know the key. There's a key, like the keystone, the one thing that opens everything is my story. Knowing that Michael Jackson was told by Diana Ross at 10 years old that he was not a Jackson, but then he was going to have to remain living with a Jackson. What that did to him, it explains everything. When you actually understand, like, everything of what Sylvester Stallone sees, he can see it all. But he doesn't understand there's one big thing missing that he doesn't understand. And it's my story that explains it.
One big ball of contradictions and confusions. Talent, without a doubt, but it came at a terrible price too. It's kind of tragic, but the truth is, the characters we play are usually the byproduct of someone else, someone else's creative mind, and eventually that's all going to crumble and fade away. You're left alive looking at yourself in the mirror, and most of them don't like what they see, and they begin to, I think, self-destruct.
Yeah, it's brutal. So, like, with Michael Jackson, like, being the byproduct of somebody else's creation, like, think about it from the beginning of, first it was Joe, right, molding him, and then it would have been Diana Ross and Barry. It's those two are tag teaming him. Once they get to, and then he's also being formed by Joe still. He's having to deal with that. So that's what I'm saying. What he got hit with there at that time, and now the pressure of these people coming at him, what he had to do and all the things, it's exactly like how Sylvester Stallone is speaking about that. You can see all these things occurred, and he knows that because he went through it too. That's like, And I've heard, like, too, and Diana Ross, she says the same thing, too, in her book, that when you're a star and you're up there, but when you come off a stage, you come down. And it's like a drug when you're high up. When you come down. And it's a hard thing to come down off of. That's why a lot of people get into drug addictions and stuff like that. And And here he's, that's what he's talking, that's why I say about with the, when the people, the kids and stuff, that they don't understand drugs and stuff, it's like, man, life and pressure is real. And that's one of these things I keep telling with you people, is like, right now I'm carrying so much pressure and weight on my shoulders, being the only one who sees all this. Like, look at all of the people. We're talking about all the most famous stars, and everybody is interested in this story, the Michael Jackson story. And right now, Michael's going through a really hard time, and he's being dismantled with the pedophile stuff. But my story is the one thing that gets through to everybody, because all of those people who think he's guilty, they're never going to change their mind with the people, the way the people, there's no way, not with what's coming at them. As long as Wade and James are going to stay, keep saying their story, the people will keep believing it, and you will, it will never be destroyed. It's just going to keep getting worse and worse. But my story breaks through that. My story will break through that and get people to see who Michael was. And then when they see who he was, then it's a, we're in a whole different world now. And then you're going to see all these kind of people like this, like the Stallones and stuff. All of them are going to come out, and they're all going to come out and start defending Michael, and they're all going to be like, shame on us. Like, people like this, I would think that, like, any people that were attacking him and all the things and all the stuff, I think everybody's going to come out and say, we all need to apologize to Michael Jackson for all of the things he had to go through. And none of us knew the true stories, and he tried his best and shit, and it turned out bad.
I hate when we see biographies of performers. The first recorded the biography is wonderful. He had children. He was rich. He had, and then come back after the commercial. The downside. And very few get out alive, emotionally alive. I've always said that an artist dies twice, and the second time he dies, the physical death, that's the easy one. The professional, the day he has to take off his mask and be, is a death. And no one respects, you're like, oh, you're just the right, you're not special anymore, you're just like me.
Like a quick down.
Yes, you're just an aging old person.
This Dorian Gray idea.
Yes, the Dorian.
Is that something that has
been? It completely.
And there's a
Dorian,
movie called The Picture of Dorian Gray. It's really good. Oscar Wilde is what he was talking about.
It really was. And I think all actors, really great actors, they have to be unrealistic. The last thing you want is a realistic actor, because he doesn't want to be real. He lives in this world,
so
this netherworld.
Yeah, that thing about he doesn't want to be real. See, that's the thing with too. It's like the marriage part with Michael, it's like, and all the sex stuff, okay, if he has a relationship, that's real. And there's a thing about with Michael, he was not willing to step in because he understood of what it meant, and that's why he prolonged it so much. And then that's what happened, is since you prolong, what happens when you prolong your natural progression, where you would have your relationship, your natural relationship, human relationship development thing, that where he would have naturally had that. And when he didn't get that, because that's the thing he needed, and he didn't get that. And when he didn't get that, he had to supplement that with something. And what he supplemented that was drugs. It's not the kids, because what people are saying what he supplemented was is actually like molesting kids and stuff. It's like, no. What he was supplementing was actually the drug stuff. The kids is just a different thing that he does for laughing and entertainment and stuff. But what you actually, the thing that where you lack the human contact, the drugs is the thing that supplements that. And that's what leads, leads him to what?
To
leads him dying and everything.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I've always, I try to put the emotional intent on there, because I know what they're feeling. I go through it myself. And this is the world I understand. Then I realized, maybe it's not so, maybe it's just a microcosm of everybody in their own little way has their own dramas, and they're not far from this either. Like when I did Rocky, I thought, well, I'm just gonna do my personal story. Then I realized it translated in every language. Everyone has that need to at least have an opportunity, otherwise they die inside. And I go, wow. That's everybody.
You see that, that need to have an opportunity, This is why I'm so mad at the Michael Jackson community, because that's the basic. It's like, okay, like what he just said, like this. I have a need to have the basic opportunity to be judged. I'm asking to be judged. I'm not asking to believe. I'm saying, judge me. I have that basic need. I have the need. It's like, you need to judge me. I need to hear you look at my work. I don't need to have my work validated, because I totally believe what I've done. But what I do is I need to know that you've heard it, because it's a big deal. Like and that's why I highlight one specific thing, my Billie Jean explanation video. That's what the one video, if I could like get people, it's like one thing, deal with that one thing, because I know that I've explained the song, and within the explanation of the song, it opens the door to everything. It's everything, because that song, my explanation of the song, doesn't make sense unless Diana Ross is telling Michael Jackson at 10 years old that she's his mother. That's what I say the whole song's about. That's, you know, so if I'm not right about the song, well, you know, then I'm not right about the, if I'm not right about the mother thing, and then I'm not right about the song, you know, but I know I'm right. And so the song says it all. That's the one song. That's the major one, is the Billie Jean. And that's why I'm going to do the Wanna Be Starting Something. I can't believe that the Billie Jean, the way that it's in there again, it's just like, geez. And at first when I was like, well, I was hoping he just like, it was going to be random, a random Billie Jean, like of the story, but it's not. It's Billie Jean. And that's what that story, the song's tricky with me. So I'm going to get to it. I'll get to that song and I'll explain. Let me see what else is here, if there's anything else.
Even though these are big theatrical, because that's the world I know, the people inside of them, underneath Michael, are very small, regular, everyday people.
So, you know, that's about it for right now. I'm going to go ahead and move on. Like I said, this Sylvester Stallone was really interesting. I like that video. I like him talking about, it's one of the better explanations I've heard about somebody describing Michael Jackson, you know, where people describe him in so many ways. But this is like a more integral, talking about the whole life experience and everything, you know. So that's why I really, but that picture so much, you know, when you see that picture there, it just has so much of it resembles this picture. And there's so much of the separation. That's what I'm saying. When they're talking about the separation that they talk about through the mind control, and it's like, no, I like Sylvester Stallone's way talking about it through being the artist and all the things that has to go with the separation. But also within, once you introduce the reality through my story about how Michael was damaged at 10 and how he really was being pulled and all the things like that, now it just turns, it opens everything up and so that's what's going to happen. We're going to find the truth, and it's going to come out. Oh, but I need to say, too, the other thing is I'm trying to make as many videos as I can. And the reason I'm not getting into this, too, is I'm trying to get as many videos as I can, because the problem is what you don't know, people, is that football is about to start, football season. And even though this Michael Jackson stuff is super important for me, my real life, the football thing, is more important, just flat out. That's more important. I have to do that. That's, and then that takes up, so all the extra time that I have where I'm thinking about the Michael Jackson story and taking the time for videos and stuff, most of my time is studying the football games and stuff. I'm going to be taking that time studying the football. So when football season comes, I really don't even want to make any more videos during football season. Like, I don't want to make any videos. I'm sure I will, and I'm sure I'll be around, and I'll be talking, and I'll be trying to make videos. But in reality, I don't want to. I don't want to make any videos during football season. So I'm going to try and make a few more videos here as best I can, do some more stuff. But like I said, yeah, pretty sure, like I said, football's coming up, and that's just like a couple weeks here. I don't want to be doing this no more. That's going to be like, I'm going to have 5 months, 6 months off, you know? So just right there, that's something, just let you people know, that's my real life thing I'm dealing with. And so, you know, I'm trying to get my story and trying to get people to start paying attention or whatever, but I don't know. It's a lot, and it is what it is. And like I said, I'm carrying a lot. I'm frustrated, and like I said, I don't understand how come I can't get Michael Jackson fans to give my explanation of the song Billie Jean. It's 15 minutes. You just listen to it for 15 minutes and hear my explanation. Don't have to agree. And the stupid people, like, first of all, if you listen to it and you're trying to prove me wrong while you're listening to it the first time, I can't even tell you how mind-bogglingly stupid of a pathetic human being you are. How am I going to get through that? How am I going to get through that kind of frickin' stupidity? So, You just have to listen to it and hear what I said. And then let evidence, as life will happen, life will start coming at you and you'll start seeing things on your own that you didn't know you were going to see, because that's how life happens. But when you're just saying no, no, and rejecting everything, then you won't see it. You're not going to get the information. Life's not going to happen for you. That's why I yell at these people. That's why people are so stupid. How can you be so stupid to sit there and be no, no, oh no, no, can't be. Oh my God. That's why I'm just so disgusted at why would you people ever allow, and it's you, you're doing it to yourselves. Why would you allow yourselves to live that kind of a form of a life? It is disgusting. And there's so much of it in here. I'll get people yelling at me, no, 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 you no, no, you can't be no. They have no idea of what I've done. They've never have taken one step to deal with any form of what I've done. And you got all of the, there's so many people that are Michael Jackson impersonators. They just yell at me. None of them deal with, it's like, okay, explain to me what I'm talking about. They can't even come clean for him close. Now, they say, you're saying Diana Ross is Michael Jackson's mom. Okay, why am I saying it? No, because you're a troll, because you're a loser, because you're evil. What freaking morons. To allow themselves to be so simplistic, what losers. And they've all done it. Even Michael Trapson.